And now, Saturday Night News presents Rich Hall's Election Report.
Hi. You know, whenever election polls are conducted, there always remains one small but pivotal group of voters, the undecided. Now, these are the people who can make or break an election. Last week, I had the opportunity to interview the chairman of the New York League of Undecided Voters, Barry Moss.
Actually, he'd agreed to meet several months earlier for a lunch interview, but couldn't decide on Mexican or Chinese. And it took me several weeks to track down a suitable meeting place, the Spanish Szechuan restaurant on 100th Street.
Well, you're certainly in a state of enormous power, what with 12 to 15% of the voters undecided. You could alter the course of the elections. Yeah.
The important thing, though, is that our party is a viable alternative for those whose traditional allegiances are wavering.
See.
Maybe the counter.
Because of the state of flux of the Republican and Democratic parties.
Well, the Republicans are in a state of flux, but the Democrats aren't fluxing.
At all?
At all. Maybe a table in the back would be good. One egg roll and just a bowl of fried rice. Shrimp fried rice. Pork fried rice. Yes. Ham steak with pineapple. No ham steak, no pineapple. Just Kung Pao chicken. And this, and the chicken, mixed Chinese vegetables, just in a nice, but no vegetables, just maybe a plain bowl of soup. Stewed crab meat, good? Is that good?
Yes, very good for today.
I don't want that. A lot of people don't understand the concept of the undecided voter. You see, the undecided voter knows who he wants to vote for, just doesn't know if he's gonna vote. Well, basically, our policy is one of cautious aggression, or casual, or careful cautious aggression. It's more a passive, casual, rational aggression than... Excuse me, do you have a dessert menu?
Yes, selective, open-minded, and given to weighty consideration of his God-given right to vote, the undecided voter is the determinant factor in the 1984 elections.
Barry.
And now with a special report, here is Mr. Blackwell.
Thank you. Thank you, Rich. He was so young. He was so young, it's disgusting. Thank you. It is so fabulous to be back on national television, really for the first time since the facelift, but more about that in our next visit. Meantime, there has been, I feel, never enough ways to say thank you to the people who do all the good things in our lives. Awards shows do some of this. There was a show this week, the Soap Opera Awards. It was unbelievable. I had the duty to witness what I call the Pearl Harbor of the fashion instinct as it is being practiced by women and men in show business today. David Hasselhoff, for an example. To take just one example, this man hosted the show. Now, I don't want to deal totally in the negative. I know I still do the worst dressed list, but I am not that person anymore. I do not like to deal in the negative. But there was more spangling going on here than at a gypsy flea market, and David Hasselhoff now was wearing a gray spangled jacket with the black peaked lapels. Not only would you not wear this to an award show, you would not wear this to Pinky Lee's funeral. Joan Collins, and again, I love the woman, I love the work, I love the statement she is making in the work, but puffy blue foil sleeves, blue foil gown. She did not look like she was accepting favorite villainous prime time. She looked like a salmon ready for poaching, and I mean that. No. And again, I feel Joan is trying to say something through this behavior, and I wish she could get more in touch with it, maybe through a spiritualist, some kind of reader. I don't know, maybe I'm wrong on that. Finally, Tony Geary, I do not know what has happened to Tony Geary. There is a thing called a comb. There was a thing called a razor and the blade and the brush and the cream. There is a thing, Tony, called a jacket. The sweater you were wearing without the lapel, without the cuffs, with the 3/4-inch sleeves, with the made out of the gray merino wool that looked like the lamb left it on the way to the slaughterhouse. Tony, this is not the way we add distinction to what I feel overall was a very credible award show, the Soap Opera Awards. More about it next time. Maybe next year we can hope for maybe better. We can always hope. That's Fashion for Now, strictly from Blackwell. Bye-bye.
Thank you, Mr. Blackwell, and good night.